Let us first understand about symmetric and anti-symmetric wave functions. In quantum physics, particles are described by some wave functions. In a system of two identical particles, the probability density, that is modulus of psi square, of the system is same if the particles are exchanged. For example, psi square 1,2 is equal to psi square 2,1. The particles are exchanged. 1,2 exchanged with the 2,1, but they are identical. The wave function psi 2,1 that represent exchange particles can be, this represent exchange of particles that can be represented as psi 2,1 is equal to psi 1,2 itself and psi 2,1 as minus psi 1,2. This is called symmetric. If psi 2,1 is equal to minus psi 1,2, it is called anti-symmetric wave functions. If particle 1 in quantum state A and particle 2 in quantum state B, two states A and B, first particle is in quantum state A and second particle is in quantum state B, then we can represent wave function psi 1 as psi A1 psi B2. That means particle 1 in quantum state A and particle 2 in quantum state B. Similarly, the first particle in quantum state B and the second particle in quantum state A, and the wave function psi 2 is psi A2 psi B1. That is particle 2 in quantum state A and particle 1 in quantum state B. The symmetric wave function is a linear combination of these two. That is, the symmetric wave function psi S is given by psi A1 psi B2 plus psi A2 psi B1 in the case of symmetric wave function, and this 1 by root 2 is the normalization constant. So this is the symmetric wave function. Similarly, anti-symmetric wave function is psi A1 psi B2 minus psi A2 psi B1 with a normalization constant 1 by root 2. This is the anti-symmetric wave function. So these are the symmetric and anti-symmetric wave functions. If the particles are bosons, the system is described by symmetric wave function. That is, wave function of a boson is psi b is equal to 1 over root 2 psi a1 psi b2 plus psi a2 psi b1. And for fermions, the wave function is anti-symmetric. That is, the wave function for fermion is 1 over root 2 psi a1 psi b2 minus psi a2 psi b1. That means bosons are represented by symmetric wave function and fermions are represented by anti-symmetric wave functions. Bosons are particle which obeys BE statistics and fermions are particle which obeys FD statistics. Let both the particle be in same state. For example, state A, then for a distinguishable particles, both psi 1 and psi 2 becomes psi A1, psi 2, that is represented by psi M, psi A1, psi 2. So if you exchange, it will be psi A2, psi 1. So both are same. That means the classical particle is represented by the wave function psi M is this one. And the probability is psi M square is equal to psi M star psi M, that is equal to psi A1 star into psi A2 star into psi A1, psi A2. This is the probability. And for bosons, this is the wave function, the symmetric wave function, and this is equal to this is 2 times psi a1 psi a2 by root 2, that is equal to root 2 times psi a1 psi a2, and its probability amplitude is psi b star psi b is equal to 2 times psi a star 1 psi a star 2 psi a1 psi a2. This is actually 2 times psi m star psi m, which means the probability of finding bosons is 2 times greater than that of classical particle, or in a same state there is more probability for finding bosons than a classical particle. In the case of fermions, this is the wave function psi f is equal to 1 over root 2 psi a1 psi a2 minus psi a2 psi a1. this is obviously equal to 0. This means we are not able to find two particles in same state, or we can say the fermions obeys Pauli's exclusion principle. And Bose-Einstein statistics. The basic postulates are the associated particles are identical and indistinguishable. Each energy state can contain any number of particles. Total energy and total number of particles of the entire system is constant. The wave function of the particles overlap. The wave function of the system is symmetric under the positional exchange of any two particles. That is why we represent bosons with the symmetric wave functions. The particles have zero or integral spin, such as 0, 1, 2, etc. Example, photon, phonon, and all mesons. These are called bosons. The distribution function is FBE is equal to 1 by e raised to alpha plus e by kt minus 1, where alpha is dependent on the particular property of the system. If the number of particles is not constant, such as in the case of photons, alpha is 0. The Planck's law of blackbody radiation. Let us consider a blackbody chamber of volume V, which is kept at a constant temperature T and filled with radiant energy that can be considered as an assembly of photons. So a blackbody chamber consists of many number of photons. So photons have zero spin, so it obeys Bose-Einstein statistics. If the number of photons in the chamber is very large, we can consider continuous distribution of energy. The number of photons having energy range between E and E plus dE is N of ED is equal to G of E by E raised to alpha plus E by KT minus 1 into dE. So the number of photon states corresponding to momentum range between P and P plus dP using last equation 2. So G of P dP is GS 4 pi V P square dP by H cube, where GS is the spin degeneracy. GS is equal to 2 for photons. It have two polarizations, that is why GS is equal to 2. And E is equal to PC for photons, and D is equal to C into DP. That is G of ED is 8 pi V square DE by HC all cube. For the case of photons, alpha is equal to 0 because the number of photons is not constant in the cavity. Some photons can be absorbed by the chamber, so the number of photons will not be constant. So in that case, alpha is equal to 0. Therefore, N of DE is equal to 8 pi V square by HC all cube. 1 by alpha is 0 means E raised to E by KT minus 1 DE. The total energy per unit volume is the energy density. Therefore, the energy density of photon is U of EDE. U of EDE means energy density, that is total energy. Energy is E, total number of particles is N of ED. Therefore, E into N of EDE gives total energy by volume V. This is the energy density, that is equal to 8 pi E cube DE by HC all cube E raised to U by KT minus 1. This is the energy density of photons in terms of energy. Therefore, the energy density of photons within the frequency range d nu, that means in between nu and nu plus d nu, is calculated by substituting E is equal to h nu and d is equal to h d nu. Therefore, E of nu d nu is equal to 8 pi h by c cube nu cube d nu by e raised to h nu by kt minus 1 by simply substituting equation 30. This is the energy density of photons in the frequency range d nu. This is called the Planck's law of blackbody radiation. So next is Stefan Boltzmann law. So total energy density of radiation in a cavity is given by integrating E of nu d nu over entire frequencies. That means from integral 0 to infinity, that we call total energy density U. That's equal to using the last equation, 8 pi h by c cube integral 0 to infinity nu cube d nu by e raised to h nu by kt minus 1. Substituting h nu by kt, h nu by kt as x, so that dx is equal to h by kt into d nu, u is equal to 8 pi h by c cube, kt by h all raised to 4 integral 0 to infinity x cube dx by e raised to x minus 1. This is a standard integral and it is given by pi raised to 4 by 15. And substituting the value of integral and simplifying, we have u is equal to, that is total energy density, u is equal to 8 pi raised to 5 k raised to 4 by 15 c cube h cube into t raised to 4. These are all constants, therefore u is proportional to t raised to 4, or we can write this is equal to a constant a into t raised to 4, where a constant is this one. Now the energy are radiated by an object per second per unit area, means the energy radiated by the black body, it can be given by r is equal to e into sigma t raised to 4. So this is the energy radiated by an object per second per unit area. R is equal to e sigma t raised to 4, where sigma is a into c by 4 and its value is 2 pi raised to 5 k raised to 4 15 c square h cube and is equal to 5.61 into 10 raised to minus 8 watts per meter square per Kelvin raised to 4, where e have values from 0 to 1. For a black body e is equal to 1 and for a perfect reflector it is 0. This is called the Stefan Boltzmann law, and where sigma is a constant, it's called Stefan's constants. Now we can find the maximum wavelength for a particular temperature, and which is called the Wien's displacement law. We have from equation 14, u of nu d nu is equal to 8 pi h by c cube nu cube d nu by e raised to h nu by kt minus 1. Substituting nu is equal to c by lambda and d nu is equal to minus c by lambda square d lambda. So from this substitution one can say the distribution in frequency is not equal to distribution in wavelength, or u of nu d nu is equal to minus u of lambda d lambda. So they are not equivalent. So by substituting these two values in this equation, we have u of lambda d lambda is 8 pi hc by lambda raised to 5 d lambda by e raised to hc by lambda kt minus 1. Here we have a minus that is simply avoided in this equation. So this is the distribution in terms of wavelength. So for a given temperature, the maximum value of wavelength can be calculated by maximizing this. That is, first calculating du by d lambda and equating it to 0. First we can find du by d lambda. Du by d lambda is 8 pi hc into we have to use a product rule here. The differential of first term, that is a differential of 1 by lambda raised to 5, is minus 5 lambda raised to 6 into 1 by e raised to hc by lambda kt minus 1 plus 1 by lambda raised to 5 into differential of this one, that is minus 1 by e raised to hc by lambda kt minus 1 all raised all square. So this is one. And differential of this is e raised to hc by lambda kt minus 1 is e raised to hc by lambda by kt. Then differential of hc by lambda kt is minus hc by lambda square kt. So that is this one. So on rearranging, we can write it is 8 pi hc by lambda raised to 6. This lambda raised to 6. And substituting hc by lambda kt as x, we have 8 pi hc by lambda raised to 6 into minus 5 by e raised to x minus 1 plus, so 1 lambda is taken out outside, x into x is hc by lambda kt x e raised to x by e raised to x minus 1 all square, where x is hc by lambda by kt. Now equating du by d lambda equal to 0 for getting maximum value of lambda. So 0 is equal to this one. So either this is equal to 0 or this in bracket is 0. So these are constants. So this is equal to 0. And simplifying, we have minus 5 x e raised to x by e raised to x minus 1. 1 e raised to x minus 1 is cancelled here. So this is equal to arranging, this is equal to 5 minus x e raised to x minus 5 equal to 0. Obviously, one solution of this equation is x is equal to 0. That is a trivial solution. Another solution can be obtained by some iteration methods. For example, Newton-Raphson method. On iteration, you are getting x is equal to 4.965 as the value of x. Now, substituting the value of x here, we have lambda max into t is equal to hc by x into k. That's equal to 2.898 into 10 raised to minus 3 meter into Kelvin. This is called Wien's displacement law. And what it gives is, if the temperature increases, the wavelength shifted towards a shorter wavelength region, or other words, the frequency shifted towards higher ranges. Okay, for a particular temperature, we can find the maximum value of wavelength from this Wien's displacement law. Now, we can do some numericals. In this problem, we want to find the number of photons present in 1 centimeter cube of radiation in thermal equilibrium at 1000 Kelvin. And what is their average energy? So we have the energy density U of nu d nu is equal to 8 pi h by c cube nu cube d nu by e raised to h nu by kt minus 1. So the total number of photons in the volume V is integrating this with, that is U of nu d nu by energy, that is h nu, into V, integrating over 0 to infinity. Okay, that is the total number of photons that can be in the volume V can be calculated from U of nu d nu. Substituting the values, that is 8 pi V by C cube integral 0 to infinity nu square d nu e raised to h nu by kt minus 1. Now we are substituting h nu by kt is equal to x and d nu is equal to kt by h dx. N is equal to 8 pi V kt by hc all cube integral 0 to infinity x square dx by e raised to x minus 1. That is equal to 8 pi is this one, V is 1 centimeter cube, that means 10 raised to minus 6 meter cube. K is given, temperature in Kelvin is 1000, h is given, c is given, all cube into this value of this integral is 2.404. On simplifying, we have n is equal to 2.025 into 10 raised to 10 photons. These are the number of photons in 1 centimeter cube at thermal equilibrium at 1000 Kelvin. Now we want to find the average. The average energy of photons is equal to the total energy per unit volume divided by the number of photons per unit volume. That is, total energy is integral, total energy per unit volume is integral 0 to infinity U of nu d nu, per number of photons per unit volume is n by v. So this is equal to we have from the Stephen Boltzmann calculation, integral 0 to infinity U of nu d nu is a t raised to 4 divided by n is 2.025 into 10 raised to 10, volume is 10 raised to minus 6, but a is 4 sigma by c and t is 1000 raised to 4 by 2.025 into 10 raised to 16. So this is, that's equal to substituting the values of 4 sigma is 5.67 into 10 raised to minus 8 and c is 3 into 10 raised to 8, and simplifying this you are getting 10 raised to minus 4, or this is equal to 3.73 into 10 raised to minus 20 joule, and dividing with a charge of 1 electron, that is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19, you have 0.23 electron volt. This is the average energy. Now in this problem, we have radiation from Big Bang, which is Doppler shifted to a longer wavelength by expansion of universe, and today has a spectrum corresponding to the black body at 2.7 Kelvin. find the wavelength at which the energy density of this radiation is a maximum. In what region of the spectrum is this radiation? So we can use the Wien's displacement law for this calculation. Wien's displacement law is lambda max t is equal to 2.898 × 10⁻³ meter Kelvin. Here we want to find the maximum wavelength. Therefore, maximum wavelength is equal to 2.898 × 10⁻³ by t. T is given as 2.7 Kelvin. Therefore, it is equal to 1.07 × 10⁻³ meter or 1.07 millimeter. This is in the microwave region of electromagnetic spectrum. So here we have a brightest part of spectrum of a star Sirius is located at a wavelength of about 290 nanometer. What is the surface temperature of Sirius? So here also we can use the Wien's displacement law, lambda max t is equal to 2.898 × 10⁻³ meter Kelvin. So therefore we want to find the temperature. Therefore t is equal to 2.898 × 10⁻³ by lambda max. Lambda max is 290 nanometer, means 290 × 10⁻⁹ meter. So this is approximately 1 × 10⁴ Kelvin or 10,000 Kelvin. Here the sunlight arrives at the Earth at the rate of about 1.4 kilowatt per meter square when the sun is directly overhead. The average radius of the Earth's orbit is 1.5 × 10⁻¹ meter, and the radius of sun is 7 × 10⁸ meter. From these figures, the surface temperature of the sun, on the assumption that it radiates like a black body, which is approximately true. So we want to find the surface temperature. So data are given. So let us first find the total power radiated by sun. For that, we consider the as a sphere, the area of a sphere whose radius is Re. Re is the radius of Earth's orbit, which is 4 pi Re square. And the rate of solar radiation falls on the sphere is power by area, P by A. That is the rate. P by A is the rate that is given by 1.4 kilowatt, means 10⁻³ watt per meter square. Therefore, the total power can be calculated as rate into area, that is P is equal to P by A into 4 pi Re square. That is, P by A is given by this one, and Re is given as 1.5 × 10⁻¹ meter. On simplifying, we are getting 3.96 × 10⁶ watt. That is the total power radiated by sun. And next, we can find the radiation rate R of the sun. For that, we can consider sphere of radius R S, and the surface area is given by 4 pi R S square. Therefore, the rate of radiation R is given by power output by surface area, that is equal to P by 4 pi R square, and P is given by 3.96 × 10⁶. 4 pi R S is given by 7 × 10⁸ meter. On simplifying, it is 6.43 × 10⁷ watt per meter square. That is the rate. Therefore, using the Stefan Boltzmann law, we can find it is given by R is equal to E sigma T⁴. From that, T is equal to R by E sigma O⁴. Here we consider it as a black body. Therefore, E is equal to 1. On substituting the values, R is given by 6.43 × 10⁷ by value of E is 1, value of Stefan's constant is 5.61 × 10⁸ O⁴, that's equal to 5.8 × 10�³ Kelvin. That means this is the surface temperature of sun, 5.8 × roughly 6 × 10�³ Kelvin, 6000 Kelvin. Now here we want to find the wavelength in room temperature. We want to find what wavelength does a room temperature object emits the maximum thermal radiation, and to what temperature must we heat it until its peak thermal radiation is in the red region of the spectrum, and how many times as much thermal radiation does it emit at that higher temperature. So we have the lambda max is equal to 2.898 × 10⁻³ by T. So T is 20 degree Celsius means 20 plus 273, that is 293 Kelvin. On simplifying, it is 9.89 micrometer. So this is the infrared region of the electromagnetic spectrum. So at room temperature, the thermal radiation is the infrared radiation. Now T is 2.898 × 10⁻³ by lambda max. Lambda max is given as 650 nanometer. That is 650 × 10⁻⁹ meter. That gives 4460 Kelvin. So if you want to make it red, we want to give this much Kelvin of temperature. That is 4460 Kelvin of temperature. Now we want to find the radiation emitted. So that is the rate. So we have R2 by R1 is E sigma. T2 means this temperature 4460, and T1 is the first temperature, room temperature, that is 293 Kelvin. That's proportional to, that is R2 by R1 is equal to T2 by T1 all raised to 4. That's equal to 4460 raised to 4 by 293. 293 means 273 plus 20. That is 5.37 × 10⁴. That means R2, that is at a higher temperature, R2 is 5.37 × 10⁴ times R1. So the radiation increases. Okay.